As a veteran, small business owner, what can we do for you?
What we can all do for all veteran business owners is promote each other.
My main mission was to look at tools of technology to leverage small business and give them more of a competitive advantage.
My mission for Red Arm Bargains is very simple, to help vets.
That story in itself, to run for Vista City Council, is a journey.
I think this is an opportunity to really collaborate with those gone before us.
It's really kind of a labor of love.
And now your host.
Happy Friday. Good afternoon. Welcome to one more episode of This Your Veteran Radio Show and Now Podcast. This show features military spouses, veterans, and community leaders while exploring heroism, action, and leadership from those that are making it happen out in our community. On the back of this particular show, we have our producer, Michael Wood, our CEO and co-founder, Joseph Molina, and our social media and engagement manager, Dali Rivera. On this particular episode, we are traveling all the way to Idaho to meet someone extremely special to our Veteran Chamber of Commerce. Of course, all of our members are very extra special, but on this particular day, Mindy Anderson, we have the pleasure of joining her, and she's joining us actually today all the way from Idaho. She is a chief motivation officer of a consulting and coaching service company, which she's going to tell us a little bit more about it. She's also the Veteran Chamber of Commerce executive director for our Idaho chapter. So without further ado, let's welcome Mindy Anderson. Welcome, Mindy. How are you doing today? And here is also our CEO and co-founder, Joseph Molina.
Hi,
welcome. Happy Friday. How is your day going out over in Idaho? How's your weather? And Joe, how's your weather over in your area?
Well, my area is just hot.
Extremely sick. So go ahead, Joe. Let's welcome Mindy Anderson. I mean, we're so delighted to have her here and to know a little bit more about what she does all the way for, from Idaho for our community and for our veteran military spouses in the local area.
Yes, we welcome Mindy, and it's a pleasure to meet you now face to face. We'll be going LinkedIn Connect all the way through, but even that way, we were able to identify true leadership, and I really, really appreciate it. So Mindy has taken the leadership of being the executive director for the Idaho Chamber of Commerce, and so yes, thank you. And with her leadership, we are already making waves and accomplishing a lot of outcomes. So thank you, Mindy. And I just wanted to welcome you to the show and looking forward to watching the interview with Laura.
Thank awesome. You. Yeah, great to see you, Joe.
Nice seeing you.
Thank you. And thank you. And once again, thank you so much for being here, for taking this time of your busy Friday day. And let's just dive into our curiosity about you and your business and your involvement in the military community. So, but first, we always like to dive in a little bit about your history. And so if I can may go back a little bit and ask you, what is the first thing you remember about your life in the military, your first experience that comes in mind?
I definitely can say that the military has saved my life in more ways than one. Over the last 20 years, it's given me a lot of opportunity. When I joined the military coming from a really rough background. I lived in a foster home growing up. I was in high school. Most of my high school years I spent living in a foster home. And I left the foster home, moved out, and went to college, and joined the Air Force with a couple of friends. There were four of us. We were all roommates, and we all decided one day that we were going to join the Air Force, and I'm still the only one that's in. So joined the Air Force and came to Barksdale, Louisiana, and just from there, it just truly changed my life. I've just met some amazing people along the way with my military career. I've just had so many opportunities. I've done a lot of really great things. I've done a lot of really cool things. A lot of people don't get these experiences that they have. And truly, you know, when I left the foster home and I went to college, I had support, but I didn't really have support. I had people that loved me and cared about me, but I didn't have family to fall back on. parents that could take care of me and help guide me along the way. But I had a team of people, and they were so proud of me, and really just joining the military has been such a blessing. So that's kind of how we landed in Idaho. We did 10 years active duty and then 10 years in the Idaho Air National Guard. Both my husband and I are military, and we just fell in love with Idaho. Beautiful place, beautiful state. And it's just been an amazing experience with the military.
That's phenomenal. That's great. And if I may just extend that, family effect to you, because welcome to the Veteran Chamber of Commerce and our family, of course. Now we are part of your family here over in the South Cal area and all across the United States. So thank you so much for your involvement, your service. So we are another part of another branch of your family now as we continue to grow together. So thank you so much for that. Now, one of the things that I was very reading and very impressed with your trajectory and your career trajectory, because you're a motivational chief officer and you're a consultant, you coach service members as well as other business owners into different things related to just, stay motivated and make a more impact in the local community. So tell me a little bit about your company, your nonprofit, your day-to-day work. What is that like, or what is your key to success?
So my company, Maximize Solutions, is a consulting and coaching business. And really, I've always known that I wanted to be able to continue to share my passion, share my journey, share my experience, and really just, something that I've always felt is a strong part of me is that I never ever wanted people to feel the way that I felt growing up. And living in the environment that I lived in. And so, over the last 20 plus years of being in the military, I've really strived to always try to lift people up and always try to support people and always try to help them feel value and feel like they're part of something bigger. And a lot of that comes from, we're growing up as kids, your brain's still developing. And so truly, when you go into adulthood, all of your experiences as a child truly shape the way that you become an adult. And so I see a lot of reason why I am the way I am and want to motivate people and want to help people is because I never want people to feel the way that I felt when I was younger. So taking that passion and taking that energy and taking those feelings and being able to put them into a company has been my greatest accomplishment, I think, in being able to support. So with Maximize Solutions, we deliver consulting and coaching services, but I like to think, and in the military, we are really great at making people a master of a jack of all trades, a Jane of none, right? And so, which is awesome because you can just adapt and you're agile and you can do anything really. And, I got a doctorate in healthcare administration, thought I wanted to be a CEO maybe of a healthcare system, but realized quickly that I really wanted to be focused on the humans. And the humans in everything that we do and processes and helping them to feel valued. And so with Maximize Solutions, I was able to just take all of what I've learned, my military career, all of my experiences growing up and put it into one basket, right, and serve in a lot of different ways. And so a lot of the clients that I work with, they require different things and they need different things, very customizable, right? And so I do a lot of different things with companies from HR consulting to organizational development and learning. I do executive team coaching. We do a lot of different stuff. And it's just really because I want to, somebody has a problem, they need a solution. We fill the gaps. We try to figure out how to get them from point A to point B without falling in the river, from point A to point B and going downstream. So it's been fun. And, the wonderful part about the military too, as well, is we're always trying to help people build their skill set to then transition into the community, right? Because we want them to leave the military with skills. And I think the military does an amazing job at making sure that our people are just ready for the civilian community and they can continue on with their career on the outside. So a lot of what I do in the military, I do essentially with my consulting and coaching business. And I think that's what helped me to be selected for the position that I've been in for the last couple of years, which essentially is HR consulting, organizational development consulting, and working with the top leadership to ensure that we have healthy culture. So it does sort of commingle a little bit, but I think that just creates, you know, more opportunity for me to be more experienced and be able to serve the civilian community and the businesses on a level and from a perspective that's unique for them. I know when I talk to clients about anything military related that don't have experience with military, it's almost like we're a foreign group, you know?
And so that's right.
They're excited to hear about military experiences because they don't have those experiences. And I think a lot of civilian people wonder what those are like, but also have great value and appreciate the military. And so
absolutely,
it's been an interesting transition.
Yeah. And one thing that we can for sure appreciate is, you know, like you mentioned earlier during sharing with us what your day-to-day in experience is focusing on the human side of individuals. And I think that's key when it comes to just progressing, expanding, and the growth of an individual or a company. When we really humanize what the need is, we can make some great things happen. And I think that's a great thing that you're doing. So now, given that also that with your company's mission, what is your company's mission and how is that ties into the military veteran community?
So our company's mission at Maximize Solution is to maximize full potential of their people and through their organization. And, you know, maximizing full potential could really be in a lot of different ways. It could be fixing processes that are broken, that are not able to, and people are not able to thrive and grow, that then leads to retention issues. It also focuses on the diversity of people as well. So I am a diversity and inclusion practitioner, and a lot of what I provide in organizational development and learning is focused on diversity. When I say diversity, it's not the demographics of diversity that we focus on. We focus on the diversity of knowledge and the diversity of thought and the diversity of personality that people have. Because we truly believe that if we're focusing on the diversity of people and how they differ from the inside out, that the outside really shouldn't matter. Because we're focusing on who they are instead of how they show up, right? And so our company's mission is always focusing on the diversity of people and their personality and their thought and their knowledge. And a lot of what we do with that is you know, we do emotional intelligence. We talk about unconscious biases. We talk about a lot of different topics that with companies that help for them to understand and just be aware that we're not trying to change their mind on how they feel, because essentially we're trying to say we want to change your personality to align with another personality. And that's not what we're doing. We're trying to shift mindsets for people to truly understand that everybody's different in the way that they think. And how do we meet the common ground with them? And how do we not agree, but how do we accept that people have a different personality and a different knowledge and a different thought?
Right? Absolutely. Absolutely. I love that. I love that because that is precisely why we are part of this veteran chamber and the CHO and everything else that we create here. And I'm so glad that you are part of our family as well, because this is how we work. We focus on one. We are one unit, one environment, one ecosystem, and we support everyone regardless of rank, you know, service, trajectory, label of armed forces background. We are just one unit designed to support. And the fact that you have a great product, a great service, a great area of support for our community that just complements absolutely what we do here. So thank you so much for that, Mindy. That's such a great great way for you to take a new perspective into the human side, but also the coaching option of developing new new services for our community and everyone out there. So, but real quick, let me recap. We are recapping here. We're talking to Mindy Anderson, who is a longstanding, has a longstanding reputation in developing, growing, and leading dynamic teams within her military and civilian career. She focuses on enhancing teams and executive coaching while still serving in the National Guard, and she's visiting us all the way from Idaho. I also want to give a shout out and say thank you to our sponsor for today, who is Bookskeeping. And by the way, we'll be talking to our sponsor later on today at 2:30. We have a very special show, and so make sure that you guys stay tuned right after. We will be talking to our sponsor from Bookskeeping, our co-founder, Max Emma. And so he'll be coming over to share what an incredible opportunity for some of those of you who have that really set ready-to-go entrepreneur mindset, plus you are have explored maybe in the future or in the past, you are thinking about becoming a franchise owner, this is a great way for you to learn more about Bookskeeping. So make sure that you join us. Thank you. So back to Mindy. Miss Mindy,
yeah.
How about you? Let's tell us. Now, you know, we all go through this so-called life journey, and we experience so many different things. And thank you for sharing your upbringing, your humble upbringing, and the things that shaped you to join the military. But if you can go back a little bit, back to your younger self, what is one thing you wish you had known or that you will tell your younger self about life that you know now?
Yeah, I would definitely say, you know, that you are where you're supposed to be always. And, you know, it really wasn't.
That is so true. I believe that. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah. And, you know, it really wasn't until a couple of years ago that I really started doing a reflection of everything and just really looking back and looking back at all my experiences, looking back at my experience growing up and, you know, where did I go wrong? And did I do something wrong? And could I have done something differently? And then looking at my experiences in the military in each, you know, position that I was in. And, you know, it really kind of dawned on me that, and it wasn't really until, you know, I heard it a few years ago when somebody said you are always where you're supposed to be, that it really set in for me. And I don't know if I was listening enough. And, you know, throughout life, if I would have heard that, I think it took me coming to this magical moment in my life where I realized that, you know, everything's going to be okay. And I am truly where I am supposed to be. And all of the experiences that I've had and all of the things that I have overcome and all of the great things that I have had the pleasure of experiencing, they all play a part in, you know, where I've come to and how I've landed here today. You know, it's really brought me to be the person that I am. And I really, you know, I think we tend to put a flashlight on ourselves a lot. And, you know, we like to dissect ourselves little by little and what have we done wrong? And we're always looking at, you know, how we could do better, but really celebrating all of the do better stuff that I've done. So I wish that, you know, I was a little more open to that phrase of you're always where you're supposed to be early on. Maybe I could have gotten there quicker, but maybe the experiences were what I needed to really get to this point, right? So
absolutely. One of the biggest things that I always like to share with my kiddos, and of course, as I grew older, I understood that just like you, you know, I kind of reflecting back on life and mementos and things that you go through. And one of the things that I know for sure for a while has been I don't have no regrets, because otherwise I would have never lived the life or the experiences or being able to make some of those mistakes or achievements that I have experienced if I was to go back and say, oh, I have that regret. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. So thank you so much for sharing that. Now, moving forward, what action item would you give or share with a veteran business owner or those that are looking to aspire to be successful based on your experience as a coach, as a consultant, and also defining your career in the military?
I would say reaching out to all of the resources that you have available as a business owner. I get a lot of calls. So I do Veterati mentorship with veterati.org, which is an amazing organization that allows for people to create profiles and then sign up to do mentorship with somebody that's similar to them that they want to receive information on how to set up a business, for example. And I get several of those mentorship opportunities. And I think there's just such a disconnect when it comes to, you know, in the military space, we know where everything is. You know, we have a global email address. We know how to look somebody up. We know who the person is that we need to go to, because there's structure and there's, you know, there's always that person that's always at the base that does those things for you, right? Like your customer service and your finance.
That's
when
right.
When you start a business and you go out into the civilian community, it's such a ping pong. You end up, you know, really ping ponging around because you're just trying to figure out, like, where are the resources? Because we don't set up businesses in the military. Businesses are set up. And a lot of the processes that we see in the military, that we see in the business side, they're handled by certain special people. And so as a business owner, you're not expected to do marketing. You're not expected to do financial stuff. You know, you really don't know how to find these resources. And there's a lot of free services. And so I really tapped into a lot of that. And one of the services that I started out with here in Idaho, I think we do a great job of supporting our entrepreneurs, is I went through a program called The Garage, and it's through BSU, Boise State University, and then another nonprofit military veteran organization called Mission 43. They sponsor with, they had the Albertsons Foundation sponsored military members or veterans or connected military members to go through a 3-month program where you get to learn the ins and outs of starting a business. So it was amazing, and it was all free. And they're still great mentors to this day. And so that's where I started. And the resources that are there, but I can tell you I hesitated about signing up because I wasn't sure if I was going to really get anything out of it. And so I'm always recommending for anybody that comes to me about how do I start a business, where do I start, I say start with the free resources. Figure out where there are, because there are a ton. And then SBA, Idaho Women's Business Center, we have here in Idaho. I sit on that board as the military advisory board member. So I get to represent all veterans and military and service-connected people in business, and it's been an amazing experience to be a part of the Idaho Women's Business Center. They are a newly funded program within Idaho. There was one here several years ago, but they have really shaked up the women business entrepreneurship in Idaho. So just lots of opportunities. There's lots of free resources. So I think if I would give any advice, it would be to constantly look for those, because they are there.
So get it all free while you can. Absolutely. While you can, get it all free, you know, all free. And if I may add, Veteran Chamber of Commerce, of course, is another link where you can get the resources. And if we don't know it, we know someone like Mindy who knows it. And so we would definitely be able to connect you to all of those great resources. And I could not agree with you more, Mindy, about, you know, how the structure in the military is. And then when you get out, whether you're trying to navigate for yourself, your new career as a, you know, as a job seeker or as a business owner, you need some of those steps or structures, you know, sort of set in place. And I found myself being challenged often by my husband, who retired after 21 years in the Marine Corps. And we always, the first couple of years, it was a huge struggle. It's like, you're not doing anything. You're not doing enough stuff. And it's like, and then I realized he's used to that green notebook and the checklist.
The green notebook.
And the green notebook and writing things down. And I would, at first, it's like, why do you still write stuff down? And it's like, oh, because he needs this structure. He needs the structure. So that's a great way for those of you who are exploring your new transition, whether that's in business or career, you know, find a good checklist that will help you get into that pathway. Now, what is that one thing, just getting ready to recap and to wrap it up, but I want to make sure that I give you a chance to for you to share with us what is next for you. What is the one thing that you would love to promote or you can share with us that we can help you and support you grow the Idaho chapter or your consulting business?
Yeah, so we're really focusing. I mean, we've got a lot of stuff going on. We got a lot of heavy stuff going on right now.
Heavy.
Heavy, very heavy. And I can feel it. I mean, I can feel it for myself, but I can feel it from others too. And we're carrying a lot on our shoulders right now. And, you know, one of the things that I thought in the beginning, I thought, well, I'm used to this. I'm agile. I can just adapt. I've done this before. I was here for 9/11. I was, you know, in the military. My future changed and, you know, what was happening, deployed quickly. So I can adapt. But the one thing that we have that's different right now is a lot of unknowns, a lot of unknowns of, you know, it's not like a deployment where, you know, you're coming back and you've got your end date and you come back. You know, we don't really know when the pandemic stuff is going to let up, and that creates a lot of worry for people. So we've had a lot of requests for emotional intelligence. We do an online virtual emotional intelligence journey where we take people on an emotional intelligence journey and how to recognize emotions in themselves and others, what to do with them, and how to let them go or accept them so that they don't hang on to you and stay with you. So we do a 6-month journey, and it's 2 hours a month where we talk about different pillars of emotional intelligence and the principles, and we develop strategies, and we hold each other accountable over the 6 months to just really support the true mindset shift. Because, you know, mindset shifts don't happen in one 8-hour course and then you walk away from it with 20% of the material and apply 5%, right?
Absolutely.
And so what we like to do, and that's really what coaching is, it's accountability. It's holding you accountable. So once a month we meet for 6 months, and at the end of the 6 months we do a reassessment and see what we've learned and see how we've been able to shift the mindset. And that's emotional intelligence alone over the last couple of years has truly, truly changed me and truly created a more healthier space for my mindset. And so we're getting a lot of requests for that right now because I think people are experiencing a lot of emotions, not really sure what to do with them and how to just navigate and channel them to positive outcomes, right? Because there's no bad or good emotion. I mean, they're just emotions. It's really all about how do you manage, how do you handle, how do you channel them to not stay with you and become that heavy, because that's, you know, that's what the weight is that's on your shoulders. It really comes down to the emotions. And so with the Veterans Chamber of Commerce, we're really starting to plug into the community, and we're hosting and sponsoring a golf tournament for Cascade Fire, which is a rural fire department that I am an EMT volunteer with. They're a great community, another family for me.
That's
they're just great, great people. So we're working on trying to support them and help them start a nonprofit too as well for like burnout funds and community outreach and scholarships. And so that's kind of what's next for the Idaho Veterans Chamber of Commerce. And then we're just going to continue to expand and grow. And I think Joe gave me the okay thumbs up and yep, let's do this in Idaho right before the pandemic started. So, but we have been really engaging, and we've been making the connections and networking with people, and it's been a lot of fun. So we're really excited about the chamber here.
That's great. And we're very excited to also be expanding out in that region, because, you know, the more of us that we can duplicate our support, our services, and just become that link, that bridge to the resources, to the network, so that others could benefit, and so that not, you know, so you don't have to carry the heaviness on your own. Mm-hmm. We have to carry the load. And that's one of the comments here that came from Dali, you know, just thank you for acknowledging the heaviness that we all are currently mm-hmm. carrying. Yes, because that is very true. We have a lot of unknowns. We have a lot of uncertainty during this time. But one thing for sure is there are a lot of great resources that are here to support you and just to, mm-hmm. you know, to be there, be a link for you, whether that is through us just talking about it, letting, you know, just being an ear for you, legal services or whatever. We have all those links that we can definitely help and support everyone. So thank you so much. With that, we're going to get ready to wrap it up. Is that And so is there anything else that we can share about you, and how can we get a hold of you, Mindy, if anyone wants to connect with you?
Yeah, so mindy.anderson@maximizesolutions.org is my email. Feel free to reach out by email. We have a website too. I see that there's some links that are posted in the chat. But you can find me on LinkedIn. You can find me on Facebook, Instagram. I have a wonderful marketing strategist that has been really great about supporting and helping out with those sites. So we're kind of everywhere.
There you go. Well, and now you're here with us through the Veteran Chamber. So that's great. In the Idaho chapter. So we're very happy that you are part of our family. So thank you so much for that. And with that, we're going to wrap it up. It's a beautiful Friday. We want to make sure that everyone gets a chance to watch the replay and then listen to us as well in the podcast on the go, because we're going to be there, Mindy. By the way, we are going to be on the podcast soon. And so this show will be available on the replay. So be sure that you share with everyone and that you subscribe and that you continue to follow and send your questions, because like Mindy mentioned, we're everywhere. So she's everywhere. So you can definitely reach out after the event and make sure that you send your questions. So thank you so much for coming. We're looking forward to at some point visiting your chapter over in Idaho and making sure that we create some great programming out there for the military community. So thank you so much. This is the Veterans Radio Show and Podcast. This show features military veterans, spouses, and community leaders while exploring heroism, action, and leadership from those that are making it happen in our community. Thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned because we have a very special show right after this. Thank you.